Dear friends and loyal subscribers, I am honored to share my latest vlog with you. My goal with these videos is to inspire and motivate others by showcasing the incredible people, places, and events I come across. I'm Joseph Saez, and I invite you to join me on my journey through life, where we will explore both land and sea together. Let's discover the world around us and find inspiration in every moment.
From people dropping a bomb to people putting up walls, I feel like life is on hold. Perception stuck in a vault. I know that time can heal all, but how much time till we fall? It's awfully chilly outside when there's no shelter to hide. When everything is a lie, you'll find that out in some time. But when the things on your mind are all considered a crime, communication aside, we'll all just fight till we die.
Is this an argument or just the start of it? Either way, I don't wanna be a part of it. Can I just get some space? I don't have the heart for this. I can't be picking up the pieces, fixing scars from this. Is this an argument or just the start of it? I wanna drive away so I can be so far from it. I wanna find a place where no one breaks their promises, or maybe drown myself in something that is bottomless. Take me back to a place where I felt at home. Take me back to a day when we weren't alone. Take me back to an age when the world felt small. Way back before we blew it all.
My blog is centered around the historical town of Angono Rizal, also known as the art capital of the Philippines. During one of my trips, I had the chance to visit Los Baños in Laguna and San Juan in Batangas with my mom and younger sister, Chachi. Looking back, it was a memorable trip as it was the last time Chachi and I were together. This November, I commemorate her as it marked her 51st birthday. I also look forward to the Christmas holiday where I get to spend with my family, relatives, and friends.
Feelings tense, don't know the consequence. The volatility of life, my only confidence. Is this an argument, or just the start of it? Either way, I don't wanna be a part of it. Can I just get some space, I don't have the heart for this. I can't be picking up the pieces, fixing scars from this. Is this an argument, or just the start of it? I wanna drive away so I can be so far from it. I wanna find a place where no one breaks their promises. Or maybe drive myself in something that is bottomless. Take me back to a place where I felt at home. Take me back to a day when we weren't alone. Take me back to an age when the world felt small. Way back before we blew it all. Take me back to a place where I felt at home. Take me back to a day when we weren't alone. Take me back to an age when the world felt small. Way back before we blew it all.
Friends. But looking back, because of the death of my youngest sister in April 2022, it's also sad to remember that 2021 was the last time we were together with Chachi.
Take me back to a place where I felt at home. Take me back to a day when we weren't alone. Take me back to an age when the world felt small. Way back before we blew it all. I know that things seem bad, but they could be much worse. There's always someone else who has a greater curse, a greater thirst, a hunger, pain, and mercy. Just find whatever you got and try to be thankful first. I wanna feel again, I need a couple friends. I never really understood just how the story ends, but I...
Thank you.
lakad ka na. Lilibot kita sa bahay ko niya. Ano para alam. Ano pa to? Mamaya magkuhanan tayo ng picture.
Ano picture na ako?
Dalhin mo dito yung mga preno. Diyan dito kayo sa ano. Upo kayo dyan.
Dito pa
may ring. Tinaas nga yung talaset eh. Natakpan lang yan eh. Dapat kita yung MRT dyan. Yung LRT natakpan yung tayo. Natakpan lang ng building na yun.
Ay, naman.
Hotel yan eh. Hindi, ito. Itong nakatakip. Ay,
ito?
Oo. Hindi yan, oh, yan. Oh, yan. Dapat kung wala yan, makikita yung LRT sa taas eh. Ito yung, ano, Mariposa Hotel yung nadasa natin.
Saan?
Ayan, yung pula na yan.
Ay,
sa, oh, yung Mariposa Hotel. Tapos yun yung barangay namin, no? Barangay Hall. Bagong tayo lang yan. Itong pandemic lang. Quirino 3A. Basta tanda mo. Barangay Quirino 3A. Project 3. Pag sasakay ka ng jeep, lagi magkasama yung Project 2 and 3. Tapos ang baba mo, sabi mo, Anonas. Yung street na yun, Anonas yan. Yan. Oh. Dati wala pa tong salamin na to eh. Pinalagay lang na ito Jojo na itong huling uwi. Dati open yan eh, kaya mahangin. Eh ngayon, pinalagyan mo. Para pag umuulan, hindi naangge eh. Nung si Tito Jojo mo na ano, na COVID, dito namin hinahati na namin ang pagkain dito eh. Dito siya nakain. Oh. Kasi na ano.
Sa third floor dito.
Ha?
Sa siya dito nagka... Hindi ko magkala na ba kayo meron din nakasitlo pa?
Ay, wala.
Dito,
dito na.
Nakasitiretso sa bayan na.
Oo. Ayan, Tito Jojo doon magbasa sa harap. Maganda nga sa nito pa para hindi naakit. Eh, pasok ka naman sa kwarto mo. Hindi video kita. Ganyan, pakita natin kila Carl. Ay, Carl Abril. Ang kwarto ni... Pinasok mo na doon sa cellphone niya, binilin mong ano? Asa na? Nagka-sakto ka siya? Madali lang palang bilhan ng ano, no case siya, no? Kasi mga latest talaga madaling bilhan yung mga... Ito, ang hirap panapan, eh. Kasi naman... This is it. Padala mo to kaya nung aking lakar ay car at April tong video. Binidyo ako si JP. Ito siya sa kwarto ni kay Jojo. Ayaw niyang mag-aircon eh. Ba't ayaw mo mag-aircon? Litipan? Tara ba tulog mo? Alas 4 ka nagising? Alas 5? Aga! Anong oras? Pagdating ba natin nakatulog ka kagad eh, nag-lunch ka pa. Ah, ganon? Wala. Baka may iwanan ka ng aeroplano. Mahirap na. Oh, sige. Sabi mo, bye-bye. I'll go na to, I'll return na to Iloilo. I'm going back na to Iloilo.
Angono Rizal. Officially the municipality of Angono, Tagalog, Bayan ng Angono, is a first-class urban municipality in the province of Rizal, Philippines. According to the 2020 census, it has population of 130,494 people. It is best known as the art capital of the Philippines. being the hometown of national artist for music Lucio San Pedro and national artist for visual arts Carlos Botong Francisco, as well as the site of Angono petroglyphs, the oldest known work of art in the Philippines. It is currently campaigning for its inclusion in the UNESCO Creative Cities Network as it is a center for visual arts. It is also campaigning for the inclusion of the Angono petroglyphs, one of 5 properties of the petroglyphs and petrographs of the Philippine UNESCO tentative site in the World Heritage List. First created as a pueblo in 1766, Angono was a barrio of its neighboring town Taytay and Binangonan before it was legally proclaimed an independent municipality in 1938 by then President Manuel L. Quezon. Etymology: the name Angono was derived from the myth of Panguno, which comes from the word Angnuno, which mean the dwarf. Geography: located 12 kilometers 7.5 miles from Antipolo and 25 kilometers 18 miles east of Manila, and with the continuous expansion of the metropolis, it is now considered part of Metro Manila's conurbation. Angono is bounded by Taytay in the north, Antipolo in the northeast, Teresa in the east, and Binangonan in the south. Demographics: in the 2020 census, the population of Angono Rizal was 130,494 people, with a density of 5,000 inhabitants per square kilometer of 13,000 inhabitants per square mile. Christianity is the major religion in the town, and the majority of all Christian denomination is Catholicism, and minority of Iglesia Ni Cristo, members Church of God International Born Again, Jehovah's Witnesses, and more. Culture: Angono is the hometown of 2 national artists, Lucio San Pedro for music and Carlos Botong Francisco for visual arts. One of the public school in Barangay Mahabang Parang is named Carlos Botong V. Francisco Memorial. The town also boasts of other artists like Nemi Miranda, also known as Nemi Miranda, Perdigon Bocalan, Jose Pitok Blanco, and the Blanco family. Around the town are artworks such as various sculptures and murals. Angono also boasts of several actors, actresses like Joey Hipolito, Freddy Reynoso, Sarayda Sanchez, Mike Tan, Nikki Hill, and BJ Tolitz Forbes, GMA TV host Harlene Ipon Budol, news anchor Sandro Aguinaldo, and film director Cati Garcia Molina. The artistic town of Angono celebrate the Feast of Pope Clement every November 22 to 23 of its year. There are times that this coincides with the Feast of Christ the King. The celebration starts with the Novena Mass on the 14th till 22nd day of November, where devotees and prayer and thanksgiving dance in the church patio after each Novena Mass. The dancing is often accompanied by the symphonic marching bands of Angono while church bells ring. The town is currently campaigning for its inclusion in the UNESCO Creative Cities Network as a center for visual arts. It is also campaigning for the inclusion of the Angono petroglyphs, one of five property of the petroglyphs and petroglyphs of the Philippines, UNESCO tentative site of the World Heritage List. Carlos Modesto Botong Villaros Francisco, November 4, 1912, March 31, 1969, was a Filipino muralist from Angono Rizal. Early life, Francisco was a most distinguished practitioner of mural painting for many decades and best known for his historical pieces. He was one of the first Filipino modernists along with Gallo Ocampo and Victorio C. Edades who broke away from Fernando Amorsolo's romanticism of Philippine scenes. According to restorer Helmut Josep Sutter, Francisco's art is a prime example of linear painting where lines and contours appear like cutouts. Later career, Francisco served as the production designer for the 1961 film adaptation of Jose Rizal's Nolime Tangere. He was responsible for the discovery of the now famous Angono petroglyphs in 1965. He was involved in costume design in Philippine cinema. His great works include portrayals of Blood Compact, First Mass at Limasawa, The Martyrdom of Rizal, Bayanihan, Magpupukot, Piesta, Bayanihan sa Bukid, Sandugo, Portrait of Frita, The Invasion of Limahong, Serenade, and Muslim Betrothal. Some of his murals have suffered big damage over the years. The Pageant of Commerce emerged from several years of restoration in 2000. His mural, The Progress of Medicine in Philippines, was restored for the third time in 2007 and is currently residing in the National Arts Gallery of the Philippines. A high-quality replica of the mural is also located at its previous location at the lobby of Philippine General Hospitals. Francisco's last work is the Kamote Diggers, which was left unfinished. Botong died on March 31, 1969 in Angono, Rizal, Philippines. The Blanco Family Museum was founded by Jose Pitok B. Blanco, a self-taught painter who was a prodigy of national artist Botong Francisco. Together with his wife, Loreto Loring Blanco, and their seven children, Glenn, Noel, Michael, Joy, Jan, Kay, and Peter Paul, they utilized their father's painting style and worked hard to achieve international fame. They achieved this feat while keeping their feet on native soil, ensuring a legacy of art. Each member of the family contributes to the museum by sharing a part of their particular collection. The family capture realism in their work, portraying the honest and humble lives of the Filipino people. They also express their love for their own country and culture. The museum is dedicated to the work of a family of self-taught painters who are now entering their third generation. It is a distinctly Filipino affair, filled with folk art style, scenes of colorful fiestas, and rural life. Michael, one of the Jose Pitok B. Blanco's children, runs the museum. It houses a vast collection of artwork produced by the Blanco family of painters. The paintings depict Angono's idyllic rural life, colorful fiesta, and religious celebrations. Jose Blanco, 1932-2008. Jose B. Blanco, the muralist and national artist nominee, known for richly colorful and celebratory works of the Tagalog pastoral, passed away last 2008. The master was 76. Blanco, whose folk realism helped nourish a town artistic heritage with works spanning almost four decades, and who went on to beget a family of prolific painter, died of heart failure. Blanco's works have been likened to that of another famous son of Angono, the late national artist Carlos Botong Francisco. Blanco's fame rests mainly on a giant oil on canvas. Through his work has been largely confined to the riverine town in Rizal between Laguna De Bay and the Sierra Madre Mountains, some 30 kilometers outside Metro Manila. With its romantic location and folk arts traditions, the town often styled itself as the art capital of the Philippines. It produced, after all, two national artists, Francisco and composer Lucio San Pedro. Nearby, Binangonan town became the residence of another national artist, painter, Vicente Manansala, Kapampangan. Blanco inspired and continued the legacy of Angono art. Blanco biography. Blanco, a folk artist, was born on March 19, 1932 in Angono, where he was known as Pitok Bungan. He was part of a long line of folk artists including Nemi Miranda, Perdigon, Bocalan, and Juan Senson, and his forefather Pedro Pison was a religious artist in the 19th century. Blanco received academic training at the School of Fine Arts of the University of Santo Tomas, where he graduated in 1955 and won the Best Thesis Award. After working as an advertising director, he left to paint full-time in 1971, holding his first one-man show at the Manila Hilton the same year. Blanco quickly became known for his mural of Angono life. His work ranged from prehistory to history, from traditional to contemporary, and are known for their graphic perspicacity and earthy colors. Blanco did not shy away from dark subjects, as seen in his work, The Burning of Angono, which recalled his painful memory of World War II. In his later years, Blanco subsumed his identity under that of his family, and his 7 children have continued the folk art tradition. Today, Angono's art scene is still vibrant, with new galleries opening and established venues set up by the Blancos and Nemi Miranda. Filipinos and tourists should not miss the opportunity to witness the great work of art of one of the finest and noblest families of artists in the Philippines. The museum accommodates an anthology of paintings by the members of the family, as well as some memorabilia throughout the years. The rural lifestyle paintings are arranged according to their place in the family and set accordingly to when they were made. Experience the pleasing and relaxing paintings of the Blanco Family Museum in Angono Rizal.
Mahal na rin mga yan, no? Mahal na rin ang mga ito. Ha?
Pamilya lang ang mga ito.
The river originates from the northeastern part of the municipality. It has a narrow and steep-sided channel that broadens out into the coast of Laguna Lake. The Angono River is the only major river system in the area, and it gently meanders through the landscape, making its way southwest into Laguna De Bay. The mayor has emphasized the Techno Demo Farm and Gulayan Bayan project in Mahabang Parang, which is part of his Upland Development Program or Sagip Bundok, Sagip Buhay Campaign. The project's goal is to protect and preserve the remaining vegetation in the upland area and prevent the construction of structures in areas covered and uncovered by the Comprehensive Agrarian Reform Program, or CARP. Dr. Alejandro Medina, officer in charge of the Municipal Agriculture Office, manages the project. One of its components is disallowing further development of subdivisions. The mayor and other major physical rehabilitation projects include the Operational Material Recovery Facilities, or MRF, located in Sitio Labahan, Barangay San Isidro, Angono, Rizal, which is managed by former councilor Danny D. Guzman. Additionally, he renovated the lakeside park and constructed the malakas and maganda sculpture in front of the municipal building. The MRF produced cement from recycled materials such as garbage and plastics, which were eventually given for free or sold at a lower price than the existing market price. Lakeside Park is a favorite jogging and leisure area of many Angono residents, where the scene at dusk is better than the Manila Bay sunset. Thank you.
how long we held it sacred. What matters is how well we love each other. It's not how far we travel on our way, but what we found to say. It's not the spring we see, but all the shades of green. It's not how long I held you in my arms. What matters is how sweet the years together. It's not how many summertime we have to give to fall. An early morning smile, cheerfully recall. What matters most is that we love at all. It's not how many summertime we have to give to Paul. An early morning smile, a cheerfully recall. What matters most is that we love. What matters most is that we love at
Peace.